pendidikan yang lebih di atasnya. Kemudian ada gugus penjaminan mutu, pengembang jurnal, kerjasama, dan lembaga sertifikasi profesi. Pengembang jurnal ini setiap tahun mengelola penerbitan 2 edisi jurnal profesi keguruan. Bapak Ibu guru yang berminat untuk mempublikasikan artikel ilmiahnya, nah bisa menggunakan jurnal profesi keguruan LP3 UNES ini. Silakan bagi Bapak Ibu yang ingin memanfaatkannya. Inilah kelembagaan dan tupoksi LP3 UNES yang diamanahkan untuk mengelola kegiatan Profesor Goto School ini. Kemudian perlu kami sampaikan kepada serta seminar, apa itu Profesor Goto School. Jadi Profesor Goto School ini dilaksanakan oleh UNES sejak tahun 2014, yang secara terus-menerus dikelola oleh LP3 bekerjasama dengan Majelis Profesor. Nah, sebelum adanya pandemi COVID-19 ini, tahun-tahun sebelumnya para profesor UNES itu melaksanakan pengabdian masyarakat dengan terjun ke sekolah, baik sebagai narasumber, seminar, workshop, kemudian ada pendampingan peningkatan budaya akademik di sekolah tentang pengelolaan sekolah dan tentu peningkatan keprofesian berkelanjutan untuk para guru. Seringkali kegiatan profesor UNES Goto School ini isinya adalah pelatihan bagaimana guru melaksanakan penelitian tindakan kelas, kemudian bagaimana menulis artikel ilmiah untuk dipublikasikan. Nah, melalui kegiatan Profesor Goto School, pada tahun-tahun sebelum ini dilaksanakan itu di sekolah atau di komunitas sekolah, di MGMP, dan seterusnya. Ini ditujukan sebagai hilirisasi inovasi pembelajaran atau pendidikan ke dunia sekolah. LPTK dalam hal ini UNES sebagai pengembang pembelajaran atau pendidikan, inovasi-inovasinya perlu disampaikan ke dunia sekolah. Ternyata Bapak Ibu, kegiatan Profesor UNES Goto School sejak tahun 2014 ini linier dengan 4 tahun kemudian Kemenristek Dikti itu meluncurkan namanya program hibah penugasan dosen di sekolah. Jadi kalau Profesor Goto School itu bisa lama, bisa sebentar, bahkan bisa hanya sekali saja memberikan sharing materi, tetapi kalau program hibah penugasan dosen di sekolah yang sejak tahun 2018 ini diluncurkan, itu dosen 8 kali minimal ke sekolah, kemudian mengajar bersama guru dengan inovasi pembelajaran yang spesifik, dan kemudian hasilnya itu dipublikasikan sebagai publikasi bersama antara dosen dengan guru dalam mengelola pembelajaran. Nah, ternyata linearitas program ini menjadi menguatkan bahwa Profesor UNES Goto School menjadi penting untuk kita laksanakan. Semakin banyak hilirisasi dari inovasi pembelajaran atau pendidikan dari UNES ke dunia sekolah. Nah, menarik bahwa dalam kegiatan penugasan dosen di sekolah, ini terjadi kerjasama yang indah antara LPTK dengan dunia sekolah untuk melahirkan hal-hal inovatif di dunia pembelajaran. Ini akan menguatkan program pendidikan guru di UNES. Ya, layaknya ketika dosen itu mengajar di program studi kependidikan, baik itu ketika S1 maupun PPG, maka dosen itu bisa menjadi role model bagi mahasiswanya. Bagaimana dosen itu menjadi contoh, menjadi teladan yang pas ketika berbicara tentang dunia kependidikan, keguruan, persekolahan. Maka ini akan bisa diceritakan secara nyata di kelas kalau dosen itu sudah merasakan peran menjadi guru itu seperti apa. Nah, melalui PDS inilah, maka ini menjadi program yang menguatkan pendidikan guru di UNES. Nah, kegiatan Profesor Goto School dengan kegiatan ini harapannya kemitraan sinergis antara UNES dengan sekolah dan masyarakat semakin indah dalam rangka memajukan pendidikan di Indonesia. Terima kasih kepada Bapak Ibu narasumber dan moderator yang telah menyiapkan diri untuk berbagi ilmu dalam kegiatan Profesor UNES Go to School ini. Pada seluruh peserta webinar, kami ucapkan selamat mengikuti kegiatan ini sampai tuntas, dan jangan lupa nanti mengisi daftar hadir yang biasanya ditampilkan dalam chat agar kami bisa memberikan penghargaan keikutsertaan Bapak-Ibu pada kegiatan ini dengan selembar sertifikat yang berbentuk soft, kemudian akan di-email oleh panitia ke email Bapak-Ibu semua. Sehingga dipastikan dalam mengisi daftar hadir tidak ada data yang salah. Mewakili segenap panitia penyelenggara kegiatan Profesor Go to School ini, kami mohon maaf apabila dalam pelaksanaan kegiatan ini ada kekurangannya, ada kesalahannya. Dengan iringan doa, semoga kegiatan webinar ini berlangsung dengan lancar, sukses, serta memberikan manfaat dan keberkahan untuk kita semua. Marilah kita awali dengan bersama-sama membaca basmalah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Demikian sambutan pengantar kegiatan ini, saya selaku Sekretaris LP3 mewakili Ketua LP3. Mohon maaf Prof. Yan, Prof. Wirupini, Bu Wuli, kami setelah ini mohon izin karena kebetulan pada jam yang sama ini ada kegiatan rapat revisi Renstra Bisnis UNES 2020-2024. Selamat melaksanakan kegiatan webinar. Kurang lebihnya dari saya mohon maaf. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Terima kasih Pak Esnarto.
Iya, sama-sama Pak.
Iya. Baik, terima kasih Bapak atas sambutannya. Kami persilahkan untuk melanjutkan agenda berikutnya. Bapak Ibu yang kami hormati, berikutnya kita masuk pada acara inti yang mana pada acara ini akan dimoderatori oleh Ibu Sri Wuli Fitriati, MPD, PhD. Beliau merupakan dosen Bahasa Inggris Fakultas Bahasa dan Seni Universitas Negeri Semarang. Biasa disapa Bu Wuli, gelar sarjana beliau dari IKIP Semarang pada tahun 1998, magister dari UNES lulusan tahun 2002, dan doktor dari University of Southern Queensland, Australia lulus tahun 2015. Saat ini beliau menjabat sebagai koordinator program magister pendidikan bahasa Inggris pasca sarjana UNES. Baik, langsung saja mari kita sambut moderator kita, Ibu Sri Wuli Fitriati, MPD, PhD. Kepada beliau kami persilakan.
Baik. Terima kasih pewara Mbak Farisha atas waktunya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Yang saya hormati Dr. Isnarto MSI, Sekretaris LP3 UNES. Yang saya hormati Profesor Dr. Januaris Mucianto M.Hum dan Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini M.Pd. narasumber kita pada hari ini, dan bapak-bapak, ibu-ibu guru, dosen serta saudara-saudiri mahasiswa program magister dan doktor. Semoga bapak ibu semua dalam keadaan sehat walafiat. Mohon izin saya Wuli menjadi pemandu acara pada pagi hari ini selama kurang lebih 2 jam ke depan. Tema Professors Go to School hari ini adalah peningkatan kemampuan bahasa Inggris tulis, yang akan dipaparkan nanti pertama kali oleh Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini selama sekitar 30-40 menit dengan judul materi Writing a Journal Article. Kemudian dilanjutkan paparan dari Profesor Dr. Zanwaris Mucianto M.Hum sekitar 30-40 menit dengan judul materi Tips to Improve Your English Grammar. Kemudian tanya jawab kurang lebih 30 menit. Perlu saya sampaikan Bapak-Ibu semua bahwa nanti ketika paparan berlangsung, chat room akan di-lock atau dikunci dengan maksud kita semua menjadi lebih konsentrasi atau fokus ke penjelasan narasumber. Begitu, nggih? Baik, sebelum kita mulai, izinkan saya membaca bio note Prof. Dr. Dwi Rukmini MPD dahulu. Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini MPD biasa disapa oleh mahasiswa Prof. Wiwi atau Bu Wiwi, adalah guru besar pendidikan bahasa Inggris di Fakultas Bahasa dan Seni Universitas Negeri Semarang. Beliau lahir di Semarang 15 April 1951. Sekarang tinggal di Jalan Meranti Raya nomor 301 Srondol Wetan Banyumanik, Semarang. Latar belakang pendidikan beliau, D3 Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris IKIP Semarang, lulus tahun 1974. Kemudian S1 Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris Universitas Terbuka, tahun 1988. S2 Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris UNES, lulus tahun 2000. Dan gelar doktor Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris dari UNES pada tahun 2007. Beliau mendapatkan gelar guru besar pada tahun 2011 dan pernah mengikuti short course English for Specific Purposes dari beasiswa pemerintah Indonesia di United Kingdom. Pada tahun 2012 sampai dengan 2015, Bu Wiwi menjabat sebagai ketua program studi S2 S3 Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris Pasca Sarjana UNES. Kepakaran beliau adalah meneliti teks lisan, meneliti realisasi struktur retorik berbagai jenis teks bacaan untuk SMA, dan mengevaluasi teks bacaan. Baiklah, saya persilahkan Bunda Wiwi, Prof. Wiwi untuk memaparkan materinya selama kurang lebih 30 sampai dengan 40 menit. Silahkan Bu Wiwi. Saya persilahkan Prof. Wiwi. Ya, Prof. Wiwi, mohon di-unmute. Audionya mohon di-unmute, Bunda. Ya, ampun. Silakan, Bun.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm so happy to meet you today. How are you? I know that most of you are my students or my ex-students. So this is our reunion. For this very special occasion, I would like to talk with you about something a bit serious. That is, writing a journal article. Hopefully you still remember my full name, Dwi Rukmini. And below that is my latest email address. Maybe some of you ask, why journal? The first reason is because as a civil servant, when someone is to be promoted from 3D to 4A for lecturers and from 4A to 4B for teachers, should have at least one article published in a journal. A journal is a channel for research communication. It is the most common method of scholarly communication. An article to publish in a journal should be based on a research. But no worries, please. Every journal has its own article guidelines, which can be learned, and we can work based on them. Now, what you should prepare before writing. Please first encourage yourself with this statement. It is not so difficult to publish an article in a journal, because I'm sure that most of you think that publishing an article in a journal is somewhat difficult. And next, keep in your mind that you are writing to communicate, not to impress. That is why what should be written should be factual and objective. And be aware that journal editors and peer reviewers' constructive criticism is to help you to write better. So don't be annoyed when they come to you. Then choose a journal for publication. You know that there are lots of journals focusing on different fields. Some literature, some English education, and some translation, for example. So choose the appropriate one. And after that, read the articles in that journal and use them as your model. And again, read journal article guidelines. The next step is to state a topic. That's why you have to know the characteristic of a good topic. First, it should be interesting to you. Otherwise, you get stuck because you are not interested in that topic. Next, you should enhance previous researchers, because the areas of weaknesses of previous researchers may inspire you what topic to write. And you also have to take into account the current trends. The current trend of this era might be online learning. Yes. And the scope should be not too broad and too narrow. This is related to the workability. I'm afraid if it is too broad, then it cannot be completed within an appropriate time. And things also about the acceptability of your article to the journal editors. The information about editors can be found at the beginning part of the journal. Might be on page I or II. Yes. Let us move to the next. Yeah, you are. The outline of journal article. It consists of 10 parts or 10 subtopics. It starts with title, and then abstract, keywords, introduction, method, result, discussion, conclusion, acknowledgement, and references. Let us stop one by one. Title. A good title should attract and inform the readers. Because without that, the readers will not continue reading your article. Next, it should be specific enough. Then, it should not include extra words such as a study of or observation on, because after all articles published in a journal should be based on a research. Means a study. Of course, if it is a study, there will be observation. and never include abbreviations in your title. The author's name is written below the article without academic title, followed with the institutional affiliation and email address. All authors should be written that way. The listing of authors depends on the contribution of each or agreement among them. Now we come to the grammatical construction of the title. The one I choose here is proposed by Soler 2007. The first construction is in the form of nominal group, like the example here. Evaluation of student-teacher's integration of educational technology into that lesson plan. It can be in the form of compound. In the example here, you can see that there is a compound or a join between the nominal group and question. It can be also in the form of a full sentence, like the example. Students' low learning motivation brings about unsatisfactory writing products, or a question. Does a good quality of model practice help in student good writing? And this is the example of title with all the followers. It starts with the title itself in the form of compound in this example. And then Sri Wahyuni is the name of the author without academic titles. And then the institutional affiliation, Universitas Negeri Semarang. And the last is the email address. Now, the abstract. An abstract is actually a brief summary of the article. It should enable the reader to review important points and purposes of the article. It should cover research background, aims, method, result, and conclusion. In the abstract, the abbreviation, acronyms, if any, should be defined here. Usually it is written in 150 to 250 words. And here is the example of abstract. Yeah, the subtitle should be written at the top in the middle. Be patient, because it is a hyperlink, we need to wait for some time. Yeah, not too long, I'm afraid. Yes. The emergence and advancement of technology with a question have impacts on the way learners gain knowledge. Yeah, this is the background of the study, and then the focus of the study is at the end of the background. The article focuses on examining the student experiences in learning English with the aid of technology and its impact on learning. The study was based on a qualitative approach with a case study design. Yes, this is the opening of explanation about the method of study, followed with the techniques of collection or use for collecting data or obtaining data. In this case, it's classroom observation and focus group interview. As well as the method used for data analysis. In this case, it's the thematic analysis introduced by Clark and Braun 2013. The result of the study is colored blue. Yes. The analysis revealed that the students seem to engage in fun learning experience. On and on, you may read it by yourself until inevitable. The parts colored pink, is the conclusion. Yes. No, not the conclusion. So sorry. Oh, yes, it is. It is the conclusion. The student, however, view integration of technology positively as it leads to the enhancement of English learning, learner's autonomy, et cetera, et cetera. Yeah. And then it is confirmed here at the end. Even though the student had limited access to mobile-based learning technology, strong learning motivation, excitement, and a positive attitude seem to help enhance that learning. Now let us move to the next part, that is keywords. The keywords should enable readers to judge whether or not the article contains materials relevant to their interests. It should provide readers with suitable terms to use in web-based searches to find other materials of same or similar topics. The form can be words or nominal group related to the article, and the quantity depends on the guideline, usually around 5 to 8. And this is an example. The keyword is written in bold and italic, and the first keyword in this case, in the example here, is technology integration, should be written with the first letter capitalized. Now we move to the introduction. Some journals do not require the authors to write the subtitle introduction. So, good night. It is very simple, isn't it? And the main contents are, first, problem the article addresses and all issues consisting of research objective, literature reviews. It covers previous studies and theories. All the readers have to know in order to fully appreciate the rest of the article. It usually ends with something new, that is the gap between the previous studies and the current studies. And at the very end, you can find research problems. Here is an example of introduction. A bit patient, please, because it is a hyperlink application. Yes, the introduction starts with the explanation about the aim of the study. Here is the, it is exploring how students of a vocational high school majoring in light vehicle engineering learn English with the support of technology and the impact of technology integration and their learning. Here, the author also explained about what she means with technology. Then the part, next, the part in red, is about the background of the study, which can be obtained from previous literature review. Here is previous study review, or the regulations of the government. Yeah. the previous research or previous research is the one written by Lubis 2018, whereas the regulation comes from the Minister of National Education number 16 2007. The explanations about previous study reviews and theoretical reviews written on and on here in the introduction part. The previous studies are usually many, and actually the author can group them based on the topic or time or method. Here seems like the topic which is used by the author to group them. Yeah. This is written on and on so clearly, because later on this will be helpful for the author when explaining the finding in the discussion part. She should refer to all the reviews here. Next is the differences between the previous study and the current study, or the novelty of the research. Here, the author wrote that the differences are on the participants. Usually, or in the previous study, the participants in terms of students are those living with their parents, but over here they live in a boarding school with limited access of internet. Another difference is the method used for data analysis, in which the one used in the current research has not been used by other researchers or previous studies. That is the one proposed by Clark and Brown 2013. And at the very end, you can find the research problem. Here we have two. First is the student, what the student gain or how the student gain in that learning with the aid of technology, and how do they perceive the impact the technology has on English learning. Now the research method. Over here, the author should give clear explanation on how the research was or is carried out. The contents are research design and approach, subject, participant, sample, scope of the study, the site, technique or instrument to obtain data, the data themselves, and how the data are or were analyzed. Here is the example. Again, this is a hyperlink application, so be patient a bit. Yeah. The approach and design of the study opens the method. The research adopted a qualitative approach with a case study design. Yeah. Here, the author also writes how she obtains the data. That is by means of a particular classroom observation and focus group interviews. After that, the authors wrote about the participants of the study, yeah, and then the policy of the government to make vocational school as a priority for high school level education. Yeah. Next is about the site and conditions of the school. It was explained in detail. The students were also exposed to the learning management system at Modo and other application, etc., etc. You can read it by yourself. Next. Again, the author explained in more detail about the technique used for obtaining data. Why observation and focus group interview were done for getting comprehensive data. And after that, how the data are analyzed or were analyzed closes the explanation about the method. Now let's move to the next. Result and discussion. The result should be presented by considering the research problem. Hopefully you remember that we have two research problem, so it should be related to these two. Yeah. And they can be in the form of tables, figures, diagram, but they should always be accompanied with text. If it is not too much, I mean, not too many or too much, it can be presented in text only. The discussion should be related to the literature review written in the introduction. Here is the example of the result. The result should be always accompanied with the evidence. Yeah. In every subtitle, the author will write the so-called introductory paragraph. And you have here the introductory paragraph. Yeah. And there is an evidence. Yes, a moment please. Yeah, the evidence.
Ini tidak bisa dilihat, Prof. Mohon maaf. Drive Google-nya, hyperlink-nya sejak tadi, mohon maaf, Prof. Tidak bisa kami lihat.
Sure?
Ya, saya sudah menanyakan ke beberapa peserta. Tapi silakan, Prof. Lanjut saja.
What about this? Can you see?
Belum, Prof. Ah, baru bisa, Prof.
Okay.
Terima kasih.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks God. I don't know. Sorry. Yeah. Yeah. The author writes an introductory paragraph related to the first question, student learning experiences in using technology. And then the first finding is that learning English with technology is exciting. And then a bit information about it. And it is supported with the evidence. In this case, is the response given while having the focus group interview that is given by student number 19. And the next finding is related to this, that is that learning English with technology is helpful and practical. Yeah, you may read it by yourself. And actually, there are three responses given by the student supporting this result or finding. But as this is an example and the time is so limited, I only give one example of supporting evidence. Yeah. And then elaboration of the author. that technology-based learning is very easy and practical, as the student can store, etc., etc. And you did it by yourself. Yes. So technology integration also instills student initiative in completing their assignment because they can use anytime, anywhere. Come on. And this is the example of discussion. Previously, before, I have told you that in the discussion, the author should relate with all information in terms of reviews of previous studies and theoretical ones here in the discussion. Yeah. Here, the author highlights the use of PowerPoint as it is obtained from Jones 2003 study, and the use of videos from Badrami and Ismaili 2016. Yeah, these two findings were confirmed by the present study result, in which students were excited with technology integration in learning. But here, actually, the author should elaborate. But as this is only an example, I cannot put all the complete discussion. Another example is that the using of types of technology encourages students to learn more to prevent boredom, which is found by Mofaret. And this is in line with the current study. Mofaret states that learning English with modern technology promotes student enthusiasm. Now let us move to the conclusion. Conclusion only answers the research problem, usually presented in paragraph. It is actually the summary of the main finding and discussion based on reviews written in the introduction. The recommendation can be written after that. Here you are. Hopefully here you can see. Can you? Bully.
Yeah.
Ya, sebentar lagi bisa ngelihat enggak diceritain ya.
Siap. Ini belum muncul, Prof.
Ya, memang belum. Sebentar lagi. Be patient, because this is a hyperlink. Ya. Can you see?
Ya. Yeah.
Can you see?
Sip, sudah. Yeah. Muncul.
Okay. To sum up, integrating technology and English classes in a computer laboratory with LCD projector and the internet was significant to a convenient learning environment. Yeah, these are all the answers of question number one and number two of research problem. Yes, what the students gain and how they perceive. Okay. Yes. Here, despite the limited access, the student came to realize that technology enhanced learning both the effectiveness of English learning, promote learners' autonomy, and improve academic attainment, learning motivation and interest, as well as digital literacy. Those are the answer of research question number one and two. And the recommendation is written here. Hence, further experimental inquiries are recommended to explore that is the effectiveness of technology enhanced English learning in the vocational school context in Indonesia. And we come to the acknowledgement. Acknowledgement is a place to thank people who help with the work but did not make any contribution deserving authorship. Those are, for example, statistical analysts, advisors, and data collectors. Yes. Sometimes it is also a place where sources of financial support are stated. But Day and Gastel 2006 reminds or advises that it is always appropriate to check whether the people in the acknowledgement are happy with what it is written. Now it comes to references. They give an alphabetic list by first author's last name of the references that the author actually cited in the article. Because this is not a bibliography. So references which only inspire you of what you need to write must not be written here. Yeah, should be what actually cited by the researcher in the article, yes. And then the basis is the latest APA 7 system. No worries, this can be accessed free of charge through the internet. Here is the example of references. And I also consider that you also have to know about the publication ethics. Because social science is a member of the Committee on Publication Ethics, or COPE. And authors writing to publish their articles in social sciences must abide this following. These are not all. I choose only important things. Any facts that may cause a possible conflict of interest of the author or authors must be taken out of the article prior to the submission. Yes, harus dihilangkan dulu. Yeah. Authors need to have the raw data readily available for presentation to the referees and editors of the journal, who knows they are required. Simultaneous submissions of articles to more than one journal is not tolerated. So it should be one. If one journal is rejected, and then you can send or submit to another journal. Republishing content that is not novel, because it is not the author's, then is not tolerated. Next, plagiarism, data fabrication, and image manipulation are of course not tolerated. Those are all from me. Thank you very much. I'm waiting for your questions and comments.
Baik, terima kasih banyak Prof. Vivi.
Is it necessary for me to also show the unseen hyperlink examples? No.
Mungkin nanti ketika ada pertanyaan Bunda bisa ditunjukkan.
Alright. Yeah. Jadi mulai dari awal nggak kelihatan?
Iya. Mulai bisa
dilihat.
Tadinya, mohon maaf Bunda, tadinya saya kira hanya saya sendiri saja, laptop saya sendiri saja yang tidak bisa. Setelah saya konfirmasi ke beberapa peserta, ternyata memang tidak bisa, baru saya matur ke Bunda. Mohon maaf juga.
Oh iya, iya, iya. Ya, ya, ya. Ya saya lupa, karena ada yang tidak compatible gitu loh.
Oke, oke. That's great presentation, Prof. Vivi. Terima kasih banyak atas paparannya tentang writing a journal article, tentang penulisan artikel ilmiah hasil penelitian. Prof. Vivi telah menyampaikan structure atau generic structure dari sebuah artikel hasil penelitian. Sangat-sangat bermanfaat, menambah wawasan kami semua, Bunda. Terima kasih. Untuk tanya-jawab, setelah paparan kedua, nggih, Bun?
Sure, love. I'm patient enough.
Baik. Mohon di turn off dulu share screen-nya, Bunda.
Oke.
Okay. Ya. Yeah. Sambil menunggu untuk ditutup screen-nya. Baik, Bapak Ibu peserta Professor Scripto School, terima kasih masih antusias untuk bersama kami di sini. Paparan kedua akan disampaikan oleh Profesor Dr. Zanuaris Mucianto M. Hum. Saya bacakan dulu biodata, sebagian biodata beliau. Profesor Dr. Zanuaris Mucianto M. Hum biasa disapa oleh mahasiswa Prof. Yan atau Pak Yan. Beliau adalah guru besar dalam bidang translation di Fakultas Bahasa dan Seni Universitas Negeri Semarang. Beliau lahir di Muntilang 13 Desember 1953. Tinggal di Jalan Kapri Raya 12, Pondok Beringin, Tamba Aji, Kecamatan Tugu, Semarang. Latar belakang pendidikan beliau, Sarjana Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris IKIP Semarang tahun 1982, S2 Linguistik Terapan Universitas Indonesia, lulus tahun 1999, dan doktor di bidang Linguistik Terapan dari UNES tahun 2011, dan gelar guru besar diperoleh Prof. Yan pada tahun 2016. Sejak tahun 2015 sampai sekarang, Prof. Yan menjabat sebagai Ketua Program Doktor Ilmu Pendidikan Bahasa atau IPB S3 di Pasca Sarjana UNES. Kepakaran beliau adalah bidang linguistik terapan, terutama translation studies. Baik Bapak Ibu, mari kita simak bersama paparan Prof. Yan tentang tips to improve your English grammar. Prof. Yan, kami persilahkan sekitar 30-40 menit ya Prof.
Baiklah, terima kasih. Ya, saya munculkan dulu screen-nya. Yeah. Kelihatan ya?
Kelihatan, Prof.
Oke. Okay. Hang on. Alright, ya. Yeah. Yeah. Oke, okay, good morning everyone.
Good morning.
I will start my presentation with a question. How long have you been studying English so far? Jadi berapa lama sebenarnya Anda sudah belajar bahasa Inggris? Ya, lama sekali. Kalau saya belajar bahasa Inggris mulai tahun 67 ya. Jadi sudah lama sekali, but then my English is not perfect. Yeah, I still make a lot of mistakes. That is why then today we are talking about tips to improve. It's not your English. It's not only your English grammar, but our English grammar, because my English grammar is not perfect also. Yeah. Okay. So tips to improve your English grammar. Now let's go on to the next one. In my topic here, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 items. Yeah, introduction, facts around us, common mistakes in using English grammar, what we need to stop making errors, practical solutions to help you improve your grammar, and conclusion. Yeah. Okay. Now let's take a look at the introduction. Yeah. Right. Why English is hard to learn? Right. I just quoted this poem from anonymous writer. Yeah. Okay. Now let's take a look at it. Yeah. We'll begin with box. Yeah, the singular is box, but the plural is, of course, boxes. Yeah. What about this one, ox? The plural form is oxen instead of oxes. goose, yeah, goose. If you have two gooses, no, we say geese. Nah. But if you have moose, then the plural form is never miss, but mooses. Yeah. Okay. And then you have mouse to become mice. House is, yeah, the plural form of house is houses instead of hais. Yeah. Man. Yeah. The singular is man, while the plural one is men rather than men's, for example. But this is convention. But when we come to the word pen, yeah, we never say two pens, but you say two pens. Yeah. Okay, we go on with other words like this. Food to become feet. Book, does it become big? No. Tooth, it becomes teeth. Booths, does it become beef? No. Right. This becomes this. While kiss, does it become kiss? No, but it becomes kisses. Brother becomes brethren. Mother, does it become mother? No, it becomes mothers. He, his, him. What about she? She becomes, yeah, her and her and hers. Yeah, instead of she's and same. So why does it happen? Yeah, it's not because English is inconsistent. It is consistent, but then there are, of course, the irregularities. Yeah? So irregular nouns. Yeah, but the problem is there are so many irregular nouns which are commonly used in our everyday life. Yeah, that is why we have to be very courteous in memorizing, understanding, and seeing the logic behind these words like that. Now, today we are focusing on this one. Yeah, facts around us. Yeah, don't read the text, the whole text, but just pay attention to the words, phrases, and clauses in yellow here. Yeah. I highlighted them in order to be clearer for us to see them. Yeah. Ini teks ini saya ambil dari proposal disertasi, ya, draft proposal disertasi. Artinya ini draft ini adalah draft yang dikirimkan untuk untuk seminar, ya. Anda lihat, ya, see there are so many yellow words, yellow phrases and yellow clauses. What does it mean? It means that there are problems with them. There are problems with them. Yeah. So many problems. They include grammatical mistakes or errors and also vocabulary errors. Okay, now let's take a look at next point. Okay, right, yeah. Oh, sorry, yeah, sorry, yeah. Okay, yeah. So Grammarly scores the text, this text, only 50 out of 10. Out of 100, ya, artinya apa? Artinya ini proposal yang di submit untuk seminar proposal disertasi itu skornya hanya 50 oleh Grammarly. Artinya apa? Artinya masih jauh, masih sangat jauh. This is still far from perfect. Ya, oke. Okay. Apa yang terjadi? Kita lihat ini teks ini ada 2,086 characters. 318 words and 18 sentences. Okay, word length 5.4, sentence length 17.7, readability score hanya 42 out of 100. Ya, jadi masih sangat rendah. Oke, kita lihat berikutnya teks yang sama. Oke, ya, ini This is from Grammarly, yeah, from Grammarly, yeah. Jadi dari 18 kalimat tadi ada 17 common alerts, ya. Ada 17 kesalahan nih. Dari 18 kalimat ada 17 grammatical errors, ya. Oke, artinya hampir setiap kalimat itu mengandung kesalahan, ya. Oke. Dan saya ingatkan lagi, this is a proposal draft which is submitted for proposal dissertation, proposal seminar, right? Next one is, nah ini, if we proceed with premium Grammarly, ya, ternyata selain 17 masalah ini tadi yang di garis merah ini, we are finding 15 more, ya, alerts yang disebut premium alerts, ya, ada word choice, ada 9 kesalahan, passive voice misuse 3 kesalahan, punctuation 1 kesalahan, incomplete sentences 1 kesalahan, dan hard to read text 1 kesalahan. Sehingga tadi saya ingatkan, this only scores 50 out of 100. Ya, yeah. So ya, yeah, kalau passing grade untuk kelulusan itu 81, ini masih jauh panggang dari api. Ya, yeah. Tuh. Ya, yeah. Ini. Jadi that is why then I remind all of you to be very courteous, to be very careful, and we have to improve our grammar, yeah, from time to time, from minutes to minutes, from seconds to seconds. We do not want you to have perfect grammar, but at least then you scores much more than just 50. Yeah. Okay, now let's go on to the next one. Nah, inilah common mistakes in English when you are using English grammar. Yeah. Ini sering kali terjadi. Yeah. Yeah, saying, I have visited Singapore last year. I have posted the letter yesterday, for example. Yeah. Okay, padahal harusnya bukan have visited, tapi visited. Okay, the woman which, yeah, you know, we make mistakes, yeah, often times, yeah, like this, woman which, woman who. Nah, ini Susie's married with a dentist, yeah. Probably we are able to say Susie's married with 3 children, yeah. Susie's married with 3 children. Susie menikah dan beranak 3, begitu ya. Ya, tapi Susie is married with a dentist. Dia menikah tahu-tahu melahirkan dentist, nggak bisa ya. Okay, so the correct one is Susie's married to a dentist. Nah, ini yang ini seringkali bahkan di seminar proposal mengatakan I am boring ya. I am boring ya. I'm boring. Kalau boring ya go away ya. Okay, ya. Instead of saying I was bored, yeah. I must to call, right? Must to call, will to go, yeah. Shall to stay, and so on, yeah. Yeah, karena ada want to go, need to go, lu must to call, shall to come, and so on, right? Yeah. Students, yeah. Ini kebiasaan bahasa Indonesia. Tiap anak-anak, misalnya, tiap anak-anak, yeah. Every students, like. Okay, then ini although blah blah blah, but we had the picnic. Ya, ada kata but di sini. Ini bahasa Indonesia. Walaupun hujan, tetapi kita pergi, begitu ya. Lalu ada influence di sini menjadi although it was raining, we had but we had the picnic. Ya. Okay, and then I look forward to after two. We usually have infinitive, yeah, to meet you soon. Padahal yang betul, I look forward to meeting you soon. Right, yeah. Nah, ini yang sering kali terjadi para mahasiswa. I very like ice cream, ya. Yeah. Saya sangat suka ice cream, begitu. I very like ice cream. Yeah. Oke. Okay, juga ini, where I can find a bank, yeah, without any inversion. Okay, I've been here 3 months. Saya sudah di sini 3 bulan, ya, yeah, 3 bulan, ya, yeah, without any preposition like this for 3 months. Yeah, the police, is the police singular or plural? Yeah, the police is coming. Yeah, okay, salah. Yeah, because the police is plural. Yeah. So we say the police are coming. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And then some more mistakes in English. You have, do you like a glass of orange juice? Enggak bisa. Kalau ini dijawab, oh yes I do or no I don't. Tapi kalau ini offer and offer, then say would you like a glass of orange juice? Okay. Ini the flight departs in 4 a.m. Apa salahnya ini? Ya, harusnya 5 minutes atau apa? In 5 hours misalnya. Tapi in 5 a.m. is salah, ya. Artinya at 5 p.m. Okay, during 4 hours dan okay, ini masih ada beberapa lagi yang lain, ya. Tapi these are all common mistakes that we face in our everyday communication, and we must be aware of them. Yeah, otherwise, then we don't improve our English. Yeah, itu. Yeah. Okay. Now let's try to see the details of my examples. What do we need to stop making errors? Yeah. Okay, this cartoon, yeah, here we have, I'll never date another apostrophe. The last one is too possessive. Yeah, so this is just a joke, but most importantly is that here we have homophones. Yeah, here we have homophones. You have there. You have your. You have it's, but remember that here we the writings are different. Here we have there, but we say there. Now there are three different things, but we always confuse the three words. Yeah. Okay. This is the example. They're going to love going there. I heard there. Oh, ini ketutupan. Yeah. Okay. Best. Okay. All right, and then we have your, yeah, your fast, yeah. It sounds similar. It sounds the same, even the same. But then with the apostrophe s here, there's a difference. Okay. Next one is it's. It's is possessive. Yeah, while it. Yeah, with apostrophe s is it is. Yeah, so they are two different things. Yeah, that's why then say to find this mistake in your writing, it is really hard. It's really hard to catch on your own, but it's a mistake everyone can make. Yeah, okay. Yeah, right. And then next point is incomplete comparisons. Yeah. Okay. Do you often hear someone says our car model is faster, better, longer? Yeah. Faster, better, longer. Is it a good sentence or not? Yeah. It's not a good sentence, because if you have a comparative degree like this, then you say faster than what? Better than what? Stronger than what? Yeah. So as a sentence, this is not a good sentence. Yeah. Okay. That's why then now ini, if you take a look at the cartoon, here we have save up to 50% off and more irregardless of your all ready bestest prices, yeah, bestest prices, yeah. Ini biasa kita katakan, ya, more better, more faster, more better, more stronger, right? Yeah, yang biasa itu ternyata tidak betul, ya, ya. Jadi better, stronger, or faster, bukan more faster, more better, more stronger. Nah, passive voice, ya, ya. Apa yang sering kita lakukan ketika membuat kalimat dalam passive? Ya, biasanya kita meninggalkan ini, ya, ya, meninggalkan to be, ya, to be. Passive when the object of blah 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 is put, ya. Tetapi in English, ya, as far as possible, we are suggested not to use passive. Ini agak aneh, ya, agak aneh. Kita disarankan untuk sedapat mungkin menghindari kalimat pasif. Padahal di dalam academic writing itu kita menghindari penggunaan agent. Ya, kalau agent pelaku perbuatan itu kita hindari pemakaiannya, mau tidak mau lalu kita menggunakan passive. Ya, ini contohnya ini. Passive happens when blah 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 a sentence is put at the beginning of a sentence blah blah blah. Ini kalimat ini diubah menjadi kalimat aktif dengan menggunakan kata the writer. Passive happens when the writer puts the object of sentence at the beginning instead of at the end. Okay, ini menjadi kalimat aktif. For common sentences it's okay, but in academic writings, yeah, it is unavoidable for us to use passive voice just because we want to avoid the use of agents, pelaku perbuatan, gitu. Dangling modifiers. Ini sering juga kita katakan. Yang tadi di teks pertama yang saya tunjukkan tadi itu ada when analyzing the children texts, it focuses on the intrinsic and extrinsic elements bla bla bla. Oke. Yang memfokuskan itu siapa? Mestinya kan ada orang, ada the writer, when the writer is analyzing the children text, bukan it focuses, tapi he atau she focuses, misalnya. Okay. Jadi karena ini descriptive phrase does not apply to the noun immediately following it. Ya, ini ada juga after declining for months Jane tried, ya, ini ya ketutup, ini ketutupnya. Oke, tapi yang betul Jane tried a new tactic to increase ROI after it had been declining for months, ya. Jadi yang decline bukan Jane, tapi yang decline itu adalah ROI. Oke, jadi ini antara ini terjadi slip, ada dangling modifiers. Oke, ya. Ini dangling juga di in this cartoon. Yang danglingnya apa? Danglingnya apa? The streets were oddly deserted that night. Ya. Jalannya itu anehnya itu deserted, maksudnya itu sepi begitu, tetapi dia dalam pikirannya itu oddly deserted. Jadi di jalan itu ada dessert yang bisa dimakan. Okay, ya. And then a brand, ya, yeah, referring to a brand or entity. Yeah. The use of they, ya. Yeah. Is it a good sentence for us to say to keep up with their changing audience? Southwest Airlines rebranded in blah blah blah. Itu ya. Jadi Southwest Airlines itu singular, ya. Singular, tetapi diberi pronoun there, ya. Katanya supaya lebih bagus, ya. Kelihatannya begitu, tetapi mestinya a good grammar would say to keep up with its changing audience, Southwest Airlines rebranded blah blah blah. Gitu, ya. Oke. Okay. They overlap between it and there. And then Nah, ini this one is the way we write possessive nouns. Ya, oke. Okay. Bagaimana kalau kita mengatakan ekor lizard? Ya, ekor lizard. Bagaimana? Ya. All the lizard's tails grew back. Itu lizardnya berapa? Kalau all, kenapa cuma satu lizard? Ya, oke. Okay. Jadi mestinya, ya, all of the lizards, ya, lizards tail seperti ini, the dog's bones. Ya, s dulu baru apostrophe, instead of apostrophe dulu baru s, begitu. Oke. Okay. Ya, ini pemakaian yang lain. Ya, kalau ini the lizards tail itu lizardnya cuma satu, ekornya cuma satu, ya, bukan lizardnya satu, ekor banyak, ya, ya itu, ya, misalnya. Oke, okay. And then the overlapping use of affect and effect, ya, affect and effect, ya. Affect is a verb, while effect is a noun. Oke, okay. Jadi kalimat ini, that movie yeah, for example, we say that movie had a great effect on me. Yeah. Tapi kalau memaksakan, you forced to use the word affect, then we say that movie affected me greatly. Okay? Okay, and then we go on with me versus I. Yeah. Me is usually used, is normally used as an object, while I is normally used as a subject. Yeah. Okay, ini dalam contoh yang berwarna kuning itu, when you get done with that lab report, can you send it to Bill and? Ya, ini di belakangnya ini ada kata I, Bill and I. Ya, salah atau betul? Kelihatannya betul ya, to Bill and I. Ya, send it to Bill and I. Tapi kalau Bill-nya dibuang, mengatakan can you send it to I? Nah, salah ya. Can you send it to I? Salah ya. Oke, okay, mestinya when you get done with that lab report, can you send it to me? Kalau Bill N dibuang menjadi to me, sehingga kalau dihidupkan lagi menjadi when you get done with that lab report, can you send it to Bill and me? Baru betul ya. Yeah. Oke, okay, ya. Yeah, yeah. Nah, saya enggak tahu ini pertanyaannya begini. Name to pronouns. Lalu siswanya ini kata, I said, who? Me? Ya. Yeah. Oke. Okay. Jadi yang ditanya saya kan? Saya ya. Yeah. Padahal ini who is a pronoun, me is also a pronoun. Yeah. Oke. Okay. And then the difference in using two with one O and two with two O's, yeah, okay. Ini this looks easy, but we often make mistakes in differentiating two and two. Okay, these are the examples, and then this one is very common, yeah, in our writing, yeah, do's and don'ts, yeah, do's and don'ts. Is it okay for us to say do's, yeah? And don'ts, ya, ternyata bukan itu maksudnya, ya. Kalau banyak do itu menjadi do's without apostrophe s. Kalau banyak don'ts, ya, don'ts, ya, apostrophe t ini apostrophe yang memang di memang ada, lalu s-nya without any apostrophe s, ya. Yeah. Oke, okay, ya. Yeah. So don't next time you write, don't say do's with apostrophe S. Yeah, but don't apostrophe S and so. Yeah, say I do have a lot of do's and I do have a lot of don'ts, for example. Yeah. Okay, and then now there is an overlap use of IE and EG. Okay, I just want to remind you that IE means that is, yaitu, atau in other words, sedangkan EG means example given or for example, gitu ya. Jadi maksudnya mau menyebutkan dengan kata lain, then you say IE. Tapi kalau giving examples, then you use EG instead of IE. Okay, and then here again you have homophones. You have pick and pick. Yeah, pick. Yeah. Okay, there are two different things. Remember, yeah, don't mix them up. Okay, and then next one is who versus that. Yeah, who versus that. Yeah, okay. These two words can be used when they're describing someone or something. Lindsay is a blogger who. Her computer is the one that. Yeah, okay. Yeah, but then here you have who, whom, whose versus who. But they are very common also, very common also. But then we sometimes make mistakes, specifically when we are using whom, whose, or whose, right? Yeah. Whose sweater is that? Who is pitching? And so on, right? Okay, and then this one, here we have a lot. Yeah. Yang a lot ini ya. A lot, yeah. It is not an English word. Yeah. Yeah. So daging kurban kemarin a lot gitu ya. A lot, yeah. Okay. Yang kita punya in English is a lot or a lot. Yeah. Ini a lot. Kalau ini jangan dibaca a lot, dibaca a lot karena ini bukan bahasa Inggris ya. Yeah. This one is a lot. This one is also a lot, yeah. They have a lot of things. You will a lot $10 to spend on gas. Okay, and then next one is into versus into. Into. This one is preposition. This one is preposition plus article. Yeah. Let's say Lindsay walked into the office. Yeah. Tapi kalau in to dipisah itu ya in dan to, misalnya call in to a meeting, for example. Yeah. Okay, and then next one we have lose and lose. Yeah, lose and lose. Lose means kehilangan. Yeah, lose kendor. Yeah, okay. Yeah, don't mix them up. Yeah, say losing your keys. It's like losing your keys. Or losing a football match. Yeah. Tapi you have I like loose clothing or a loose tooth. Yeah. Giginya kendor ya, yeah. Loose tooth. Yeah. Okay, and then this one is difference between then and then. Yeah. Then and then. They are also homophones, yeah. My dinner was better than yours. Salah ya, yeah. Karena for degrees of comparison, you use then rather than the first then. Okay, we made dinner and then we added. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Nah, ini we rarely use this one, of course, but for those who like to use shoulda, coulda, and woulda, itu there can be a problem karena could have. Ya, yeah, should have, could have, would have itu kedengaran seperti should of, yeah, would of, atau could of, should of, or would of. Padahal harusnya itu you do not say should of, could of, atau would of, tetapi should have, ya, should have, could have, would have, ya, oke. Jadi in your writing, instead of using shoulda, coulda, woulda, then it's better for you to use I should have done, I could have taken, I would have done, and so on. Yeah. Okay. Kalau mau disingkat, bukan sudah, woulda, coulda, tetapi should have, should have, could have, would have. Yeah. Itu. Kalau pakai F menjadi should have, yeah. Should have. Yeah. Okay. And then, nah, punctuation, yeah, commas, specifically commas, yeah, okay, yeah. Now just imagine, yeah, just imagine if you say let's eat grandma, yeah, let's eat grandma, yeah. Ini grandmanya lari, ini nggak mau, ini mau dimakan, yeah, yeah. Padahal persoalannya itu with the comma, let's eat grandma, yeah, okay, yeah, eat, yeah. Ini this always happens when we separate three or more nouns. For example, I brought a jacket, a blanket, and an umbrella. Yeah, here we have comma, here we have comma. Yeah, in the part. Yeah, independent clauses. You have and, but, for, or, nor, so, and so on. Nah, kita lihat. My brother is very smart, comma, and I learned a lot from him. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We often forget to put a comma here to separate two clauses using and like this. Yeah. Okay. Then right. Comma is also used to separate the introductory words or phrases with the main clauses. For example, here you have in the beginning, comma, I had no idea. Yeah. However, comma, after reading, yeah, blah blah blah. Nah, ini saya temukan di teks yang pertama saya tampilkan tadi, ada comma harusnya, tetapi ditinggalkan comma itu. Yeah. Okay, and then assure, ensure, dan ensure. Yeah, assure, ensure, ensure, right. Ini yang ensure dan ensure ini it's matter of British English or American English, ya. Yeah. But assure is something different. To assure means to promise or say with confidence. I assure you, saya meyakinkan kamu that he is good at this job, ya. Yeah. To ensure or to ensure sama ensure you're free when I visit next weekend, ya. Yeah. Ensure is almost the same as this one, ya. Yeah. I told you that ensure is British English, ensure is American English. Ya. Nah, ini yang bagian ini, yang ada kartunya ini, we are finding this kind of notice, itu di counter, ya. 10 items or less, 10 items or less. Lalu dibetulkan jadi fewer, okay. Ya. So, 10 items or less. Yeah, whereas the correct one is 10 items or fewer. Yeah, because items is singular, is countable noun. Yeah, item countable noun. So 10 items. Yeah, tapi less is used with non-countable nouns. Yeah, jadi fewer road trips, less traveling. Traveling is uncountable, while trip is countable. Okay, next one is semicolons. Yeah, I usually find out that students are reluctant to use semicolons. Yeah, what is the use of semicolons? Yeah. Okay, karena ragu-ragu, ya, lalu semicolons tidak pernah dipakai atau jarang sekali dipakai. Semicolons are used to connect two independent clauses that are closely related to one another. Call me tomorrow. I'll have answer for you by then. Okay. Between the first clause and the second clause, here you have very close relationship. Yeah, that is why instead of using two clauses or two sentences, we just use semicolon. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. There's another sentence. Yeah. Okay. Complement. Yeah. They are homophones also. Complement and complement. They are homophones, but they have different meanings. Yeah. Complement. Yeah. If something complements something else, melengkapi complements. Complement, the other one, is an expression of praise. Yeah. Yeah. You have an example. A wine selection can complement a meal, melengkapi a meal. You can compliment your friend's new haircut. Compliment, mengapresiasi atau ya mengapresiasi begitu ya. Okay. Father and further, ya father and further. Father is used more to refer to physical distance, while further is used more to refer to figurative or non-physical distances. Paris is farther away than Madrid. A marketing team falls further away. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I have no further questions. Okay. And then dash. Yeah. Ini, this is called N dash, while the longer one is called M dash. Yeah. Kenapa disebut N dash dan M dash? Ini kakinya cuma dua, ini kakinya tiga. Jadi satunya N, satunya M. And and M dash are both versions of the M dash. You can use either the N or M dash to signify a break in a sentence. You can use either, yeah, N dash or M dash. Yeah. That will take 5 to 10 minutes. Yeah, here. You use N dash, but of course you can substitute it with M dash. To be or not to be, that is the question. M dash Shakespeare. We can also use N dash instead of M dash. Okay, and then capitalization. Ini yang agak susah itu kalau kita membuat judul seperti ini. Judul seperti ini itu dipisahkan capitalizing nouns, pronouns, adjectives, verbs, adverbs, and subordinator conjunction and subordinators. Yeah. Lower case articles seperti a and the itu coordinating conjunctions, prepositions menggunakan lower case. Yeah. Jadi kalau kita buat capitalize di komputer itu of-nya akan di-capitalize, the akan di-capitalize, ya, yeah. Oke, okay. To akan di-capitalize. Makanya this is the only way to correct this kind of writing is manual correction, ya, yeah. Manual correction, grammar, police, common, grammatical errors. We and all, stop and making are content words. Yeah, they are capitalized. Tetapi yang lainnya of, the, and then the, to itu adalah kata fungsi atau function words. Yeah, they are not capitalized. They are in lower case. Yeah. Okay, and then between and among. Yeah. Selalu kalau between itu selalu hanya dua, ya. Between is only used to refer to two, ya. Walaupun kadang-kadang sometimes more things, ya. Tapi bagaimana kita mengatakan you choose between a red shirt and a black shirt, ya. You walk between Center Street and Broad Street, ya. Tapi kalau lebih dari dua sebaiknya kita menggunakan among, ya, walaupun ada yang pakai, ya, sometimes ya more than two words, ya, difference between Tom, Jerry, and John misalnya, differences between Tom, Jerry, and Tom, Jerry, and John for example boleh, tetapi prinsipnya between two things, among more than two things. Okay, yeah. This last word will stop correcting my grammar. Okay, I do not want to stop correcting your grammar. Yeah. Okay, these are the practical way. Yeah. So it seems that time is almost up. So I will be very quick in reading this part. Practical solutions to help you improve your English grammar. First, make a commitment. You have to commit. That grammar is very important for you to make sentences communicative. Ya. Jadi kalau komitmen tidak ada, kita asal-asalan saja memakai grammar, maka bisa terjadi misunderstanding. Ya. Seperti tadi, I want to meet grandma. I want to meet grandma. Ya. Keep a grammar book and a dictionary at your disposal. Grammar book dan dictionary harus siap digunakan setiap saat. Seperti sekarang juga di hadapan saya ada dictionary yang selalu siap. Yeah. Utilize a grammar application. And then practice every day. Yeah. Is it still necessary or unnecessary for us to practice grammar every day? Yeah. Because you have been studying English for years, right? Saya sudah belajar bahasa Inggris sejak tahun 67 sampai sekarang itu sudah berapa puluh tahun, ya sudah lebih dari 40 tahun pun setiap hari saya masih membuka kamus, ya. Oke, jadi you can never be tired of learning English. Yeah. Learning new words, ya. Yeah. Oke, mungkin di antara Anda tadi baru tahu bahwa ada N dash and M dash ya, baru tadi tahu ya, sebelumnya nggak pernah tahu ya. Oke, atau tanya-tanya kenapa yang ini pendek, kenapa yang ini panjang, apa maksudnya begitu ya, nggak pernah ditanyakan, you just take it for granted ya, padahal ada maksudnya. Learn new words, read more English, you read and read more English ya, rather than Indonesian itu ya. Oke, saya masih menemukan ya, in your thesis or dissertation proposal itu Anda masih menggunakan referensi pakai bahasa Indonesia, Sutrisna Hati, siapa lagi ya, Sutrisna Hati, lalu si siapa, banyak ya, banyak metodologi bahasa Indonesia ya. Then why don't you read English books ya, why do you read Indonesian books, even though the Indonesian books are important, right? Usahakan untuk membaca juga yang bahasa Inggris, read more and more and more in English. Okay. Listen to English, ya. Listen to English, ya. Okay. Listen from the radio, listen from TV, listen from everything, ya. Okay. And try to communicate in English with your teacher and friends, ya. Yang ini yang mungkin cukup susah, ya. Cukup susah. Try and communicate in English with your teacher and your friends, begitu, ya. Okay. Tapi setiap ada kesempatan, then it's okay to communicate in English with your teacher and your friends. Yeah. Watch English movies. Yeah. Watch English movies or TV series. Write more English. Yeah. Write more English. Understand the logic behind grammar and rule. Selalu ada logika dalam pemakaian grammar in English. Okay. Right. This is the conclusion. Okay. I dream of a world where one day people will have an opportunity to learn spelling and proper grammar before they create memes on social media. Kenapa? Karena ternyata social media itu lebih banyak merusak our grammar dan merusak our spelling rather than meningkatkan itu. Okay, thank you, Bu Buli.
Baik, terima kasih banyak Prof. Yan atas penjelasannya yang sangat komprehensif mengenai common mistakes in using English grammar. Dan alhamdulillah 293 peserta masih mengikuti acara kita pada hari ini, pada pagi ini. Saya persilahkan host untuk membuka chat room. Namun demikian, saya prefer peserta yang akan bertanya atau menyampaikan tanggapan untuk raise hands begitu. Dan ketika bertanya, mohon videonya dinyalakan, Bapak Ibu. Okay? Terima kasih. Silahkan Prof. Wiwi, mohon di-unmute dulu audionya. Silahkan saudara
yang tadi yang
sebutkan nama atau institusi dan pertanyaannya atau tanggapannya sejak poin. Silahkan. Silahkan. Saya belum melihat ada yang raise hands. Atau bisa dengan menulis di chat room. Oh, silakan Mbak Herni atau Ibu Herni Karya.
Terima kasih waktunya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saya Budi, Sunaria Bana dari SMP Negeri 2 Wangun sebagai pelajar bahasa Inggris. Pertanyaan pada
salam.
Pada siapa? Asalnya nggak usah adem ya,
sayang. Buru-buru angkone nolong ngarepe ku yang
Halo.
Silakan Bu Herni.
Ya, saya bertanya pada Profesor Yan, bagaimanakah cara mengajar yang baik ke siswa supaya siswa bisa meningkat vocabulary-nya? Padahal tadi saya sangat asik sekali, sangat tertarik sekali pada profesor saat mengajarkan kepada kami pada saat persepsinya di tampilan layar. Itu saja, terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Prof. Yan menghendaki langsung menjawab atau bagaimana? Prof. Yan?
Ya. Inti pertanyaannya apa tadi, saya agak ini ya mengganti dengan headset itu kelewatan.
Oh begitu. Baik, saya persilahkan Bu Herni, mohon maaf diulangi lagi karena tadi Prof. Yan sedang transisi mengganti headset. Silakan Bu Herni. Bu Herni.
Ya, unmute. Ya.
Bu Herni.
Ya, Bu Herni.
Ya, ya terima kasih. Nyun sewu Pak Profesor Yan, nyun sewu, bagaimanakah teknik mengajar ke siswa sehingga siswa bisa mudah menguasai kosakata atau menguasai vocab-nya, Pak?
Ya.
Itu okay. Saja terima kasih.
Ya, ya. Ya, terima kasih. Langsung saya jawab Bu Wuli ya.
Supaya silakan Prof Yan. Ya. Mohon maaf ini Bu Dewi Fatica share screen, tolong dimatikan Bu Dewi Fatica. Ya, silakan Prof Yan.
Ya, ya. Jadi bagaimana mengajar kosakata? Dulu ketika saya di sekolah begitu, ada yang menganjurkan supaya sehari 5 kata, sehari 6 kata, atau sehari 10 kata. Nggak bisa, tidak bisa ya. You will never be able to ask the students to memorize, just to memorize words. Tidak bisa, ya, tidak bisa. Jadi yang bisa dilakukan ialah you ask the students to practice, ya, practice using the words, ya. Jadi ini guru SMP ya, guru SMP tadi ya.
Iya, yeah, harus Pak.
Ya, ya, guru SMP ya. Yang saya amati di beberapa sekolah di SMP itu banyak di antara guru itu tidak mengajarkan bahasa Inggris, ya, tidak mengajarkan bahasa Inggris, tapi mengajarkan grammar bahasa Inggris dalam bahasa Indonesia. Ya, itu yang terjadi. Ya, itu yang terjadi. Nah, sebab itu harus di switch. Ya, sekarang harus di switch bahwa mengajarkan bahasa Inggris, to teach English should be in English. Ya, oke, harus diulangi. Itu kata Jack Richard ya tahun 1980-an itu mengatakan to teach English in English ya, oke, bukan to teach about English tetapi to teach English. Jadi mengajarkan bahasa Inggris itu dengan memberikan praktek ya, praktek latihan, bukan hanya disuruh untuk mengingat. Tapi kalau mengingat kata sehari lima kata ya tanpa tahu pemakaiannya ya cepat lupa ya memang teorinya itu kalau satu hari lima kata satu tahun itu 700.000 kata ya berat, tapi tidak bisa jadi okay, in order for you to implant the habit of using words in English, then you ask the students to practice them, give them more and more practice in our everyday teaching, right? Ya, jangan terlalu banyak didominasi oleh guru dalam pelajaran bahasa Inggris di kelas, tetapi berikan kesempatan kepada siswa untuk praktek memakai bahasa Inggris baik lisan maupun tulis. Oke, itu ya. Oke, ya, terima kasih.
Thank you. Professor Yan, thank you for your answer, and it is very useful for me, and I will practice it in my student. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih Bu Erni atas pertanyaannya. Saya informasikan Bapak Ibu bahwa materi sudah di-share oleh pewara di room chat. Silakan tanggapan atau pertanyaan selanjutnya. Tampaknya tadi sudah ada dua peserta yang raise hands. Mungkin Mbak Farisha bisa membantu saya, siapakah yang tadi sempat raise hands?
Titi, Ibu Titi.
Ya. Bu Titi, silakan ya. Bu Titi.
Ibu Arina Yuliarti.
Oh, Arina. Ya.
Bu Titi dahulu atau Bu Arina dahulu? Silahkan yang siap, Bu Titi. Oh tidak, Bu Arina mungkin. Bu Titi sedang mencoba meng-unmute gadgetnya. Silakan Bu Arina. Mana Bu Arina?
Can I start?
Yes, sure.
Okay, thank you so much. So I have a question for Professor Wiwi.
Suara kurang jelas, Bu.
Yeah. Okay, sudah?
Volume.
Sudah. Okay, thank you so much. So I have a question for Professor Wiwi. It's nice to see you, ma'am. It's been 4 years because I am class of 2016. Yeah, graduate program.
Assalamualaikum.
So, Prof. Wiwi, I have a question related to the steps of... Okay, can I continue? Okay, so I have a question related to the research step. Oh, sorry, writing journal steps. So, actually, the steps is very clear, and then I understand most of the explanation. But I have a question related to how can I measure the validity and reliability of my research, ma'am? Because before I start writing the journal, I need to measure the validity and reliability of the research results. So can I do something like, you know, asking someone or what can I do to validate the result of my research? Thank you, Prof. B. Because I'm a teacher, and then I don't have any, you know, like someone to consult, such as like advisor or such kind of that. Thank you so much.
Okay, can I answer directly, or should I wait?
Yes, please, Prof. B. You can answer directly.
Yeah. Thank you, Ibu Arina. Yeah.
Yeah, welcome, ma'am. I miss you.
I miss you too. For the validity and reliability of the results of your research, I think, do you have Ari Kunto?
Yeah. Yes, yeah. Ari Kunto.
Okay, there are lots of information about how to measure validity and reliability. But if, okay, you have a senior colleague, don't you have so?
In my school, actually, I have 2 or 3 senior colleagues, but still, so? I need like a lecturer, maybe, because we are all teachers.
Okay, so you can have your ex-lecturer to help you.
Okay, can I contact you maybe, ma'am?
Yeah, if I have time. But okay. I think, yes, I will have time for you.
Okay, no. Thank you so much. Maybe yeah. In the
but
future.
But of course, okay, find your senior.
Yeah, I will.
Yeah, and to read Ari Kunto, which is in Bahasa Indonesia, hopefully it gives you lots of information about validity and reliability, yes, of the result of your research. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Did I answer your question?
Yes, and it is very clear.
Thank you.
Thank yeah. you, ma'am.
Terima kasih, Bu Wiwi dan Ibu Arina. Saya sampaikan sekali lagi, Bapak-Ibu, bahwa materi PowerPoint Prof. Yan dan Prof. Wiwi sudah di-share oleh Ibu Farisha tadi sekitar pukul 11.01. Mohon di-scroll up. Karena ada beberapa pertanyaan yang masuk ke room chat menanyakan materi. Sekali lagi saya sampaikan sudah di-share oleh Farisha, pewara kita hari ini. Sekitar pukul 11.01. Baik, kita lanjutkan tanya-jawab. Silahkan. Atau saya bacakan pertanyaan dari chat dulu, nggih, Prof. Wiwi dan Prof. Yan.
Boleh, boleh.
Dari Abdul Salam. Dalam belajar bahasa Inggris, ada 2 output utama, yakni speaking and writing. Bagaimana menjadikan writing test atau making a text or paragraph interesting for students? Thank you. Silahkan Prof. Yan atau Prof. Wiwi.
Writing. Writing. Okay. Can I answer?
Ya, silakan Bu Wiwi.
Yeah, okay. Because it is a text writing, I think what you have to do is to choose a topic based on the student's interest. So the text will be meaningful for them. Yeah. You know what I mean? The title. Mm-hmm. Abdul Salam, where are you, Pak Abdul?
Pak Abdul Salam.
Oh, I see. Mungkin bukan Android, jadi nggak bisa. Okay. Pak Abdul, choose a topic by asking your students to state by themselves. For example, if it is describing, and then they can describe not just members of the family, but also friends of them, or their idol, yes? Or maybe you yourself as the topic to write, yes. You know what I mean? Choosing a topic is very important, yeah. And ask your student write objectively. What I mean, which is meaningful. Jadi, kalau misalnya mau menulis tentang orang yang mereka tidak tahu, itu ya jangan. Karena itu tidak meaningful. Misalnya membuat I love brown. Brown ki sapa to kira ngerti lo. Ya. Terus Anda menulis yes. mengenai the zoo.
Yes,
di kampungnya itu enggak ada kebun binatang. Bayangannya kan angel. You get my point?
Yeah. Yes, yes ma'am, yes ma'am.
Yeah. Find interesting topic and meaningful one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
okay ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. This is okay. Only one of the advices. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. There
yeah. Oke, okay, ya.
Silakan, Pak.
Thank you, Bang.
Ya, dalam hal grammar ya, itu bahasa Inggris. Saya tidak tahu sekarang ya, tapi ketika saya masih mengajar, saya dulu pernah mengajar SMP, mengajar SMA, mengajar SMEA, ya, sebelum mengajar UNES. Itu tampaknya saya merasa bahwa bahasa Inggris itu bahasa Inggris itu pelajaran yang paling ditakuti setelah matematika, gitu ya. Mata pelajaran yang paling ditakuti itu matematika.
Oh iya iya. Kedua, iya, iya. Bisa juga Prof ya.
Betul ya. Sampai sekarang masih itu ya. Masih bahasa Inggris paling ditakuti. Kenapa paling ditakuti? Gurunya galak-galak begitu. Termasuk saya juga dulu galak mengajar bahasa Inggris ya. Oke. Ternyata ketika saya membaca lebih banyak buku metodologi pembelajaran, itu ternyata kita bisa melihat banyak teknik pembelajaran yang membuat agar siswa itu menjadi tertarik. Ya, jadi yang membuat bahasa Inggris, grammar terutama, itu membosankan atau tidak menarik atau menakutkan dan seterusnya, itu sebenarnya bukan pada grammarnya sendiri, tetapi ternyata pada bagaimana guru menyampaikan itu. Ya. Ya, jadi ada satu buku yang mengatakan, dan saya menyaksikan sendiri dulu suatu SD di Australia, di Sydney itu saya melihat para siswa itu nakalnya, kalau menurut ukuran orang sini, itu para siswa SD itu nakalnya bukan main begitu ya. Jadi sulit sekali diatur begitu ya. Nah, kalau di sini wah gurunya udah gurunya senewen terus ya, nggak bakal. Ternyata gurunya itu bisa mengambil teknik ya bermain, ya teknik bermain, teknik games, teknik nyanyi, teknik macam-macam yang membuat siswa itu berubah konsentrasinya dari konsentrasi mereka melakukan kegiatan sendiri menjadi semua tertarik pada bahasa Inggris itu ya. Nah, pada waktu itu saya lihat di Sydney itu bukan bahasa Inggris pelajarannya, itu matematika. Ternyata matematika bisa menjadi mata pelajaran yang sangat menarik bagi siswa kalau kita menggunakan teknik yang tepat. Jadi silakan klik di internet saja interesting techniques to teach grammar atau interesting techniques to teach writing in English. Di sana Anda akan menemukan banyak teknik yang bisa digunakan dalam pembelajaran grammar dan writing dalam bahasa Inggris. Oke, begitu saya kira. Ya.
Terima kasih Pak Ian. Selanjutnya ini ada yang raise hand, Ibu Ika Holifatul, kalau tidak salah. Ibu Ika? Ibu atau Mbak Ika
Holifatul? Iya. Ika, iya.
Silakan.
Okay, thank you for the time. I'm going to ask Professor Dwi Rukmini. Can you hear my voice?
Mm-mm, sure, very clear.
Okay, thank you. It is my own problem. I often find difficulties in writing, especially the difficulties is choosing the topic. Or I know Dwi say that writing is not in order to impress, but we just to discuss something. But sometimes I find difficulties in choosing the topic. Maybe Dwi has suggestion for me how to find the topic easily to write or to discuss in the article. Thank you.
Oke. Langsung direspon oleh Bunda Wiwi, silakan, Bun.
Halo.
Mohon unmute, Bun.
Belum bisa mendengar.
Suaranya belum terdengar.
Sudah? Ya.
Sudah bisa, sudah tak unmute.
Sudah itu.
Oke, ya. Tadi tidak melihat a good character. Oke, the characteristic of a good topic. Tidak lihat tadi, ya. Yeah. Yang pertama itu harus yang menarik bagi Anda apa itu, ya.
Yeah.
Tanpa itu Anda tidak punya bahan untuk ditulis, ya.
Yeah.
Nah, jadi topiknya itu harus menarik untuk Anda. Dan kalau itu mengenai research, yang Anda tulis itu harus factual, ya. Harus objektif, jangan lebay, ya. Terus Anda bisa baca banyak artikel dan weaknesses, kelemahan-kelemahan artikel itu bisa menginspirasi Anda untuk topik yang Anda harus tulis. Habis itu Anda baca-baca dong, ya.
Referensi literature-nya, ya.
Sure. Terus the current trend. Kalau sekarang current trend kan lagi apa coba?
PJJ, pembelajaran jarak jauh.
Ya, yeah, home.
Iya.
Yeah. Anda tulis mengenai problems of online teaching. Itu kan bisa menarik banget toh.
Iya. Tulisnya mesti. Yeah, sometimes for new topics, I find it difficult to find the references or the literature to support my article. That's the problem. Or maybe I less reading.
You can find in the internet.
Yeah, I see.
As long as you write keywords appropriately, then you can find millions of articles related to what you have. Okay. Search. Yeah?
Yeah.
The topic should be not too broad and not too narrow. Yeah, kan? If it is too broad, I'm afraid it won't be completed within, a short time. Yes? And then? Not too narrow. Jadi yang pas gitu loh, ya. Dan yang Anda kuasai banget. Kalau Anda kuasai, Anda bisa menari-nari di situ, ya. You can dance. This your article. Do I answer your question,
my love? Yeah, thank you.
Sure?
Sure. Thank you. Yeah, yeah. One thing that I get the point from your answer is find the weaknesses from articles that I read. I never find the weaknesses. I just sometimes to get the topic, I just read and then try to make another method or another a problem. Never find weaknesses. And you give me one suggestion. Find the weaknesses so that we can find the topic. Thank you so much.
Welcome, love.
Yeah, baik.
Kan sudah belajar lama, mesti banyak pengalaman. Yeah. IT mesti ngapusi, gitu kan? That's the weakness.
Baik, Bapak Ibu, waktu menunjukkan pukul 11 lebih 16 menit, kita punya waktu sekitar 14 menit, nih, sampai 11.30 nanti kita tutup. Banyak sekali Prof. Wiwi, Prof. Yan, pertanyaan lewat chat room ini. Tadi saya sempat membaca, tapi saya kembali lagi tadi tidak ketemu. Ada yang menanyakan tentang bagaimana jika UNES mengadakan pengabdian pada masyarakat tentang penulisan jurnal.
Ya, itu langsung saya jawab. Itu concern. Concern Bu Wuli dan saya dalam waktu yang tidak terlalu lama lagi ya itu Bu Wuli dan saya akan mengadakan pengabdian pada masyarakat sekaligus ini sebagai pengumuman ya Bu Wuli bahwa akan ada dua topik. Ya, saya akan menyampaikan topik yang berjudul from apa? From dissertation to book, ya. From dissertation, dari disertasi bagaimana mengolahnya menjadi buku, ya. Ya. Lalu Bu Wuli nanti akan menyampaikan kalau nggak salah itu from thesis to articles, ya. From thesis to article. Jadi bagaimana mengubah tesis itu menjadi artikel, ya, menjadi artikel. Mungkin satu artikel, mungkin dua artikel, mungkin tiga artikel, bergantung pada research question begitu. Yeah. Demikian juga ya, nanti yang S3 yang sekarang masih sedang menulis disertasi, atau bahkan yang sudah selesai menulis disertasi, disertasinya jangan disimpan di rak saja, ya. Kalau sudah lulus, ya, itu masih bisa bermanfaat untuk diubah menjadi buku, ya, menjadi buku. Yang kalau terbit itu bisa dibaca banyak orang. Kalau disertasi atau tesis itu kan hanya dibaca oleh penguji, ya. Pengujinya 4-5 orang membaca pun tidak komplit, ya. Baca lalu menguji, habis itu sudah, ya, sudah rubbish bin begitu, ya. Tapi kalau Anda bisa mengubah itu menjadi artikel, itu akan disimpan oleh orang, akan diterbitkan oleh satu jurnal. Dan UNES itu ada PPS UNES misalnya, itu mempunyai 18 jurnal, ya, yang bisa dikirimi artikel dari Anda. Demikian juga kalau books itu, sebagai contoh itu dari disertasi saya dulu, itu saya berhasil menulis dua buah buku, ya, dua buku yang ditulis dari satu disertasi. Jadi dan itu lebih bermanfaat karena bisa terbit dan dibaca lebih banyak orang. Saya kira itu dari saya.
Ya, baik. Sekalian Prof. Yan, ini ada pertanyaan dari Ibu Titi Nurhayati, Sarjana Agama. Beliau bertanya, how to write a good grammar in research of PTK?
Apa saja? Jadi PTK itu bisa mencakupi apa saja, ya, ya, termasuk grammar, ya, ya. Jadi how to teach grammar, ya. How to use certain techniques in teaching grammar, ya, to the first year students of blah blah blah. Begitu, enggak masalah. Jadi grammar itu sangat sangat luas, sangat sangat fleksibel untuk dipakai sebagai objek dalam suatu penelitian, ya. Mungkin itu jawabannya.
Ya, ya, baik. Dari Ubaidillah Karomi, Pak Yan dan Bu. Yeah. Ini pertanyaannya, saya baca di sini, bagaimana cara membuat siswa tidak takut berbicara setelah belajar banyak tentang grammar? Bagaimana? Mungkin Bunda Wiwi? Biar Kak Yan istirahat sebentar. Bagaimana cara membuat siswa tidak takut berbicara setelah belajar banyak tentang grammar? Dari Ubaidillah Karomi.
Dibiarkan dulu dia bicara, habis itu baru kita koreksi. Ya, ini bicara kepada seseorang atau bicara ketika pidato. The person asking, can you please tell me this is speaking to somebody or speaking in front of the audience?
Silakan Pak Ubaidillah Karomi untuk muncul videonya dinyalakan Pak Ubaidillah Karomi karena Bunda Wiwi menanyakan maksud pertanyaan. Ya, silakan Pak Karomi.
Yeah. To everybody, Mom. Even ya, meskipun untuk mereka sendiri juga. Ini pengalaman saya sendiri juga. Karena yang terlintas di mereka structure-nya, Mam. Karena mereka lebih fokus ke structure, jadi kalau ngomong itu kayak harus ngeluarin rumus dulu, Mam. Kira-kira begitu.
Harus melalui apa?
Ngeluarin rumus.
Rumus. Nggak apa-apa dong, mereka mengeluarkan rumus, mengeluarkan dictionary, terserah. Jadi didiemin aja. Jadi jangan mereka salah, terus langsung dibetulin. Itu This will make them discouraged to say things. So just keep, okay, your student speak until completed. Then you note down, yeah, the errors or mistakes, and after that you can improve. See what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I see, ma'am.
Yeah, if it is okay, dialogue between your student and you, or between your students and you as a teacher, then if the mistake is all right, what I mean is that if the mistake can be tolerated, and then just ignore that.
Okay, okay.
If the comments in writing, yes. Jadi selama Bapak tahu itu ya biar aja. But later on, yeah, you write the mistake and the correction and give it personally in writing to the very students. Do I answer your question?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Okay, saya tambahkan sedikit ya. Jadi ya ya, kenapa gurunya pertama? Yang pertama, kenapa gurunya harus menguasai English grammar, ya, English grammar seperti yang tadi saya katakan itu harus betul-betul dikuasai dulu oleh guru. Itu karena itu adalah apa? Basisnya, ya, basisnya, ya, basisnya. Jadi kalau gurunya tidak tahu bagaimana mengajarkan kepada muridnya, nah, bahwa kemudian muridnya itu masih terus-menerus membuat kesalahan, itu tidak apa-apa. Itu namanya bahasa Inggris yang dipelajari oleh siswa itu kan namanya interlanguage, ya, interlanguage. Jadi bahasa siswa yang akan berkembang terus, berkembang terus, berkembang terus, makin lama makin mendekati bahasa Inggris bagaimana yang dipakai oleh native speakers. Ya, jadi nah kalau di kelas itu lalu mereka tidak mau atau encourage atau discourage to speak, itu memang menjadi tugas guru untuk memberikan motivasi. Tadi saya katakan bahwa bahasa Inggris itu bahasa Inggris itu paling ditakuti kedua setelah matematika. Sekarang bagaimana menghilangkan trauma bahwa bahasa Inggris itu bukan sesuatu yang menakutkan, tetapi sesuatu yang interesting, ya. Oke, jadi jangan sampai siswa mengatakan I am boring begitu, ya. Oke, ya, kalau sekali mengatakan I am boring, ya dibetulkan menjadi I am bored begitu. Tetapi usahakan supaya siswa itu tidak bosan dengan mata pelajarannya. Bagaimana? Anda tidak akan bisa mengatakan, Anda jangan bosan ya, Anda harus tertarik ya. Tidak bisa. Anda, itu kata-kata yang Anda berikan kepada siswa, anjuran kepada siswa untuk tidak bosan dan untuk tidak untuk selalu tertarik, itu useless ya, useless. Jadi motivasi yang diberikan kepada siswa itu berupa motivasi yang tersembunyi di dalam aktivitas yang Anda berikan, misalnya melalui games, melalui songs, melalui outing, ya, melalui puzzles, ya, banyak cara. Apalagi di SMP SMA itu banyak sekali cara di mana siswa itu bisa termotivasi untuk terus belajar belajar sambil bermain begitu, ya. Saya kira itu tambahan.
Baik Pak Yan dan Bu Wiwi, satu pertanyaan terakhir nggih. Tentang dari Subhi. Intinya bagaimana mengajarkan bahasa Inggris secara online terutama pada saat seperti sekarang ini? Begitu pertanyaannya Pak Yan dan Bu Wiwi.
Bu Wiwi masih mute ya. Oke, okay, ya. Jadi bagaimana secara online itu secara prinsipnya itu memang mengajarkan online itu lebih susah, lebih susah dalam hal menyiapkan materi, ya, dalam hal menyiapkan materi. Tetapi sebenarnya setelah materinya disiapkan itu kita akan bisa menggunakan media online itu secara lebih luas, secara lebih lebih luas dan secara lebih luas. Jadi misalnya saya mengajarkan bahasa Inggris di S2 dan S3 karena tidak bisa tatap muka semester yang lalu itu kita bisa melihat materi dari mana-mana, dia mengambil materi dari mana-mana, dan kita menambahkan komentar dari mana-mana. Jadi kalau Anda guru SMA misalnya, klik aja di internet itu materi pembelajaran bahasa Inggris untuk SMA, di situ akan banyak sekali hal, banyak sekali materi yang bisa dilihat. Itu kita mengajak para siswa untuk bersama-sama melihat materi-materi yang ada di internet itu. Tapi kalau misalnya Anda cukup kreatif untuk membuat materi-materi yang bisa disampaikan online, itu akan lebih baik kalau Anda buat materi itu sendiri ya, atau bersama grup di dalam sekolah ya. Bagaimana caranya? Gunakan semua teknologi yang Anda kuasai untuk disampaikan kepada siswa secara internet. Dan sekarang ini selain Zoom yang sekarang ini kita pakai, ada Google Meeting ya, ada macam-macam. Saya sampai nggak tahu itu jumlahnya berapa itu ya. Banyak sekali yang bisa digunakan ya. Oke, ya. Yang paling sederhana sebenarnya adalah video call ya. Tapi video call itu terbatas, paling banyak hanya 8 orang kan. Ya, tidak bisa lebih banyak dari itu, sehingga itu sangat terbatas ya. Google Call itu paling mudah karena hampir semua siswa itu mempunyai wahana gadget itu ya. Ya, gadget ya. Tapi itu sangat terbatas. Jadi mungkin Zoom seperti ini itu sangat bermanfaat ya, di samping Google Meeting ya, dan yang lain-lain ya. Ya, saya kira itu ya.
Baik, terima kasih Pak Yan. Selanjutnya Bu Wiwi, apakah
ya mau menambahi sedikit aja. Ya, kita beri masukan sedikit. Habis itu kita kasih tugas yang menuntut mereka untuk membuka internet. Dan mereka kadang-kadang menemukan melebihi yang kita kira. Nah, dari situlah ada semacam merdeka belajar. Dan itu kayaknya yang diminta sama Mas Menteri ya, disosialisasikan ke sekolah-sekolah. Jadi jangan menganggap anak-anak itu bodoh terus. Mereka bisa menemukan hal-hal baru ya. And we even can learn from them. Ya. Dan dia bisa mengakses kemana-mana karena nah, masalahnya adalah sekarang masalah kuota itu, karena kuota mereka itu terbatas. Itu masalahnya. Apakah itu yang juga merupakan masalah Bapak atau Ibu tadi yang tanya? Kalau seperti itu, ya lewat sekolahan. Tapi kan nggak bisa ketemu ya. Ya nggak bisa dong. Apa kelurahan, apa... Ya sekarang pemerintah kan menawarkan banyak sekali bantuan-bantuan untuk pembelian kuota. Ya, itu saya kira. Jadi nggak usah diberikan semuanya. Kalau diberikan semuanya, kita bisa-bisa hanya menghadapi laptop terus sampai air matanya tanpa henti mengalir. Ya kan? Nah, itu saya kira bisa diatasi atau disiasati dengan memberikan sedikit, tetapi nanti menunjukkan Anda bisa mengakses ke ini dan Anda akan dapat blah, dan mereka akan kreatif. Begitu? Do I answer your question, love?
Yes, sure. Thank you. Baik, Bapak Ibu peserta Professors Go to School pada pagi hari ini, alhamdulillahirabbil alamin, saya haturkan terima kasih kepada Prof. Yan dan Prof. Wiwi yang telah berbagi ilmu, pengetahuan, dan pengalaman mengajar bahasa Inggris kepada para peserta pada hari ini, peserta dari Jawa Tengah, Jawa Timur, dan juga dari Jawa Barat, dan ada juga dari Sumatera tadi. Karena waktu sudah menunjukkan pukul 11.35 menit, saya mohon maaf jika saya tidak bisa mengakomodir pertanyaan-pertanyaan yang disampaikan lewat chat room. Insya Allah lain kesempatan, mudah-mudahan kita punya waktu dan kesempatan untuk
event yang lain sehingga diskusi kita ini bisa kita lanjutkan kembali. Atau jika Bapak Ibu peserta ingin berdiskusi lebih jauh kepada Prof. Yan dan Prof. Wiwi, saya rasa beliau berdua sangat welcome untuk menjawab pertanyaan-pertanyaan atau diskusi dengan Bapak Ibu sekalian. Demikian Bapak Ibu, kita akhiri acara diskusi pada hari ini. Saya selaku moderator, Wuli, mohon maaf yang sebesar-besarnya jika selama memandu acara ini ada kesalahan atau kekhilafan saya. Mudah-mudahan bermanfaat untuk semuanya. Sekali lagi saya haturkan terima kasih Prof. Yan, Prof. Wiwi. Kita akhiri dengan membaca hamdalah. Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim.
Baik, untuk penutupan saya kembalikan acara ini kepada Mbak Farisya sebagai pewara. Silakan Mbak Farisya.
Terima kasih Bu Wuli. Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim, usai sudah program dan rangkaian acara webinar yang telah kita simak hari ini, kami ingatkan kembali kepada Bapak dan Ibu untuk mengisi daftar hadir yang sudah kami bagikan tautannya dalam live chat agar sertifikat dapat segera kami proses. Mohon nama, gelar, dan email yang diisikan sudah benar dan sesuai. Bapak Ibu yang kami hormati, demikianlah tadi serangkaian acara webinar FBS UNES Professors Go to School dengan tema peningkatan kemampuan bahasa Inggris tulis guru dan dosen. Kami ucapkan terima kasih atas partisipasi Bapak dan Ibu sekalian dan tentunya terima kasih kepada para narasumber, Bapak Ibu Profesor, serta moderator yang telah membagikan ilmu kepada kami hari ini. Mudah-mudahan acara ini bermanfaat dan menjadi ajang yang baik untuk saling silaturahim. Terima kasih atas perhatiannya dan mohon maaf apabila ada kekurangan dan kesalahan. Selamat siang. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih, Mbak Farisya. Mas Ari sebagai host, terima kasih. Mohon di-unmute biar...
Terima kasih.
Terima kasih.
Thank you.
Halo peserta. Thank you.